And now, The Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Can't get enough of that new theme song. Back to Tool, everybody. It's The Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Big J. Oakerson. That sexy man is Dan Soder.
Screaming.
That's right. Oh, it's nice. It's nice to have him back.
Feels good. It's like putting on a new old coat.
This is Lost Tapes Thursday, and we're sitting here kicking it. Mulling over what to shoot the old shits about.
I'm currently in Colorado smoking medical marijuana.
Are you right now?
Right now, at this moment, I'm driving up to the mountains.
Is that what's happening?
Yeah, I would listen to the show, but I've never activated my Sirius account. So I have to bootleg my own show when I listen back to it.
You going this weekend to Denver?
Yeah, I got a bachelor party and a funeral. Two of the most
wow, opposite. That is really...
Real morbid. That's and it goes real, bachelor real party first.
Really?
So it's like, yeah, fucking Josh is getting married. And then it's like Luke drank himself to death.
What kind of...
Which is legitimately the two things that I'm going for.
What bachelor party? What kind of bachelor party? Is this a... everyone's getting their dick sucked?
No.
It's like a bro out.
It's a bro out. It's a house up in the mountains. All my friends that like... It's my best friend's older brother that was kind of like our older brother. And so it's all his friends. We got a big house up in Lake Dillon, Colorado. So... And I don't drink, so I'm only going for a limited time.
The bachelor party concept is so weak.
You know what it is?
It's so lame.
It's been, yeah, so now it's just a reason for all of us to meet up, and they're all going to get fucked up. I'm going to probably do drugs and watch them. Judging.
Just like...
Watching.
Judging and watching them.
Look at the baby. Look at the baby.
I don't know. I guess I worked, so not very long, I guess, but I worked enough, like... Bringing those girls to bachelor parties that I just see, they were just like, ugh.
Dude, if they bought...
What a weak-ass hang.
If I would... Nothing would make me happier tonight. And I'm saying tonight as in... Because this is Thursday.
Sure.
Nothing would make me happier than if they got some mountain stripper for the cabin. Some buck-ass woman with calloused hands.
Oh,
how you doing? I'm Lenore. Here's the deal. I'll touch one of your peckers, but for an acre of land, if I'm going to make you come, it's going to cost you territory.
Now, I'm going to take off my top panties, and you guys can play around with those. I would not go near the ones touching fur.
Okay. Let me tell you something about me. I live up in the high, high mountains. I came down for this.
She's offering her buddy. She goes, yeah, you want a lap dance? Hooch.
Yeah, she goes, kiss my belly, but just watch my happy trail. I haven't had to whack it down.
Oh, fuck, a stripper with belly button hair?
Yeah. She goes, you put on John Denver, you better get a mop because I'm going to get sopping wet.
Oh, man, you really know what blows my A out?
Oh, you give me the Flying Burrito Brothers, and I'm going to start squirting all over this goddamn place. Yeah, so we're going up, and it's like we're doing, like, you know, daytime activities, guys in their 30s activities.
Dude, that's like, the touch football.
Yeah, nothing where we can get hurt, but also where we can feel athletic.
2-on-2, a couple games of 2-on-2.
Dude, and I know these guys, the competition runs like deep. There might be a fist fight with all the activities. There probably will be one because it's mostly, It's my friends, but we're the younger ones. So it's Josh, my friend's older brother, and all his friends who are older, but they're all basketball players. So most of them are like 6'6". So it's like, if you're going to want to take one of them out.
Does a part of you wish it wasn't happening at all?
I like it. I love, Josh is one of my closest friends. So I'm happy to do
that though,
but I'm happy to go back to Colorado because I was just there for Comedy Works, which ruins any hang because you're doing shows. So it's like you hang, sure. But then around 5 p.m. you're like, I got to go get ready for the show. I have to go perform two shows.
Right.
So this is fun to go back to Colorado just for the weekend of doing, just hanging out. I mean, Saturday is going to be a bummer, but
yeah,
my friend is dead. So
kicking into the funeral.
Dude, that's so weird to go from bachelor party to fucking, because it's so such funny. The opposite way around where you should be like, God rest in peace. You tear off the tie like, yeah, let's party. Yeah, booze and chicks. But to go from that to being like, I'll see you tomorrow. Let him rest.
Everyone's so sad.
And that he died of drinking is kind of fucking weird.
That is
to go from a place that's based on drinking to a thing.
Isn't it ironic?
Don't you think? It's like booze on your funeral day.
So everyone's going to be getting, you don't really, there's got to be a stripper situation.
I don't know. I don't think so.
I guess you don't want to call it out on radio.
No,
are you giving me the wink right now?
No, not at all. I'm telling you right now, I have no fucking clue. I hope there's a stripper.
Stop winking. I get it, dude.
I'm not going to be drinking. I want tits and
Dan,
ass.
Stop pinching me. I get it. I'm not Jay, I'm not saying it anymore. Dan, fine. Okay. No hookers. Fine. Sorry.
Okay. You guys aren't going to have a fucking, a bus of stolen teens.
It does not
sound
like a fun bachelor party. If I go to a bachelor party, there's got to be hookers there. That's right, Lou.
Big J bachelor party. We give you all the regular bachelor party, but with more puss, more diseased puss than you can handle. Do you want a woman who was beaten and locked in a closet and now finds her profession sucking off married dudes? Well, Jay's bachelor party weekend's for you. And then hit me with John Denver, Rocky Mountain High for mine. Because Jay's like, fucking, sucking, and then more booze. My bachelor party is,
I'll say why he pulls that up. My thing with bachelor party, it's weird, my trickle down.
Yeah.
I don't understand going to a strip club is not full nude.
Yeah.
I don't understand going to a topless bar or a bikini bar. It doesn't make any sense to me. If you're gonna go, if you're gonna go see not naked women, then let's just go try to meet women at a place, you know, at a bar.
I agree with you. I completely agree with you.
I get the married man, I guess, concept of it, but like, I don't know. It's never really struck me that much.
Yeah.
So if you're gonna go, let's go see some full nudity.
Have some Coors Cutter. Have some nice
bachelor party.
Non-alcoholic beer while you watch a woman show her pussy. It's always the creepiest feeling.
A bachelor party where the strippers aren't also, fucking? I don't get it.
So just if they come in and strip, you don't get?
No. If it's that, let's go to a strip club then. Let's just do that. If they come to the fucking place you're at, like the last thing I want is a girl to awkwardly come in with some dude who's watching her to fuck, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
like,
to not fuck.
I don't know. It's just like, and by the way, I'm all fine if it's
Do you feel like it's the version of boxing with the big gloves and the headgear where you're like, you're really not getting it done?
Yeah, it's foxy boxing.
Yeah. Let's get some real shit in here. Let's get some kumite going.
That said, by the way, before I saw a girl, just topless, I'd rather see foxy boxing.
Okay. I like topless, but I'm Vanilla Dan.
Really?
I like a nice, you know, boobs in a room is fun. It's not like all the appeal, but
how does it still strike you now when just like...
I think hotter girls...
Last Sunday we went to Panorama Fest.
Yeah.
And I mean, like, I saw... I was standing next to my daughter, and I saw 13 nipples.
Oh yeah. I mean, I saw it. But I'm saying like, I'm not saying that does it for me, but also girls that tend to just do topless bars tend to be hotter. The hotter ones don't show their puss.
Shit, if they know what's good for them, they will.
Well, if they're broken enough,
hang on, let me take my pinky ring off. Yeah. If they know what's good for them, they will.
Yeah. I mean, yours is, yeah, you want prostitutes who fuck and go full nude. My bachelor party is,
oh my gosh.
Hey, if you want to have some eggs on the deck with your friends and kind of catch up, then maybe we'll play some frisbee golf. I don't know. We're going to get crazy today.
We'll meet nice girls wearing overalls and we'll hold their hands and go to a soda shop together.
Oh, maybe one of my friends will bust out some Jack Johnson around a log fire as we all sit in shorts and sweatshirts.
Maybe we'll go down to the Bob's Big Boy and get a 5-cent Pepsi Cola.
Oh, I would like that. And then I would like to maybe come back and Just watch the sun go down.
You're Brendan Fraser and that grew up in a...
Yeah, Blast from the Past.
He grew up in a fucking bomb shelter.
We just want to have a nice guys get together as opposed to Jay.
I was calling Dan the Beeve.
Hey, Beeve. Hey, Beeve. I'm going to shut up.
I'm fucking
Wally.
I'm the asshole next door.
You're
Eddie Haskell.
Eddie Haskell. You're all, hey, Mrs. Cleaver, can I see your pussy?
Hey, Mrs. Cleaver, nice box.
A modern day Eddie Haskell. He's all, Eddie. Hey, Eddie, I got these. He goes, why don't you bring the Beeve down here? We're going to smoke some meth and fuck these runaways. You're all, Jesus, Eddie Haskell.
Eddie, is this your webcam in my toilet bowl? Hey, Mrs. Beeve.
Hey, Mrs. Beeve. Funny your name's Beeve because I think about your pussy all the time. She goes, I don't want Eddie Haskell here anymore.
Yeah, Eddie Haskell has to go.
Eddie Haskell's not allowed in this house. So yeah, I mean, we're gonna do that.
Like, hey, dude, enjoy your bachelor. I'm not here to, I am judging your bachelor party, guys, a little bit. But, yeah, but we don't even know what's gonna happen yet.
I have no clue.
They're not telling you, stool pigeon.
Yeah. They know I'm gonna sing like a canary. I'm already giving it away right now.
What's the most sans girlfriend?
Yeah.
Cause I, one thing I believe about Dan Soder is your honor.
Yeah.
I do. I might even say that ironically, by the way.
Oh.
You're like, oh, it seemed ironic.
That felt real ironic.
Free and clear, single Dan, do you hookers there? Do you do anything with them?
Yeah, I'd probably try to get a beach.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, maybe not get a beach.
I get a beach. At first, I'd look at their teeth the way vets look at dogs' teeth.
You lift their lips with your thumbs. Like you're fucking, like you're checking if a Terminator looks human enough.
Yeah. Or the hook from Robin Williams where he's pushing her face back. I go, there she is. There's the reason.
Shit.
Yeah. I'd probably try to go for, honestly, I know you mock me for it, but a titty fucking in that situation, it's actually, you sleep a lot better.
I to go back to teeth for a second, I watched an episode of Hoarders today. I was in a Hoarders spiral today.
Oh, always fun.
Always fun. It does make you feel better about yourself, but really bad at the same time. A lady had three teeth only on top.
Yeah.
And it looks like they were like stickers though. Like they look like they were completely thinned out. It was just like the fronts of three teeth. Like they were, and they went all the way up. They were super long.
Yeah.
Like there was no gum over. It looked almost impossible.
I told you.
But she was one of those. She had like 15 cats and just lived in their shit. Mm-hmm. She was a bedwetter.
Mm-hmm.
And just slept on her own piss and catch it every night. It's amazing. And there's like,
I'll tell you this, that's a woman.
Like, they're like, I love my, they always go, I'm a collector.
That's the woman that's a woman you want to travel with. Someone that'll sleep in her own piss. You're not going to get too many complaints at an airport if someone's sleeping in their piss. She's like, I'm hungry. I go, you sleep in your own piss. You go, why don't you just shut up?
Desert Island? I want that to grow to be my island mate.
Oh, that's such a great island mate where I go, where were you? She's like, just shitting in my little dirt hole. God, you know, you really are the best, Cheryl.
Thank you.
Yeah, she goes, I'm glad we crashed together, too. You were saying the teeth thing. One of the guys I worked with in Alaska, one of my dock bosses, and I've said this, had teeth on the top right side of his mouth, and then no teeth on the bottom right side of his mouth. And then he had no teeth on the top left side, and teeth on the bottom left side. So when, and it fucking went as a diagonal when it met the middle, so he had a perfect clasp. So he would be yelling at me, and I would just be so intrigued with how his mouth was like
lined up.
Dude, I wouldn't even hear
like
half
the bottom
shit.
And the top would just miss each other on the way down.
Like no, like it would be like, like it was built. Like you know when they're running through space stations and the doors close, like in between hallways.
Uh-huh.
That's how his mouth closed.
Like an airlock.
Yeah, like an airlock. Like
when he opens his mouth, it goes.
Hold on, it's not taking out. No, he's into space. The food just flies out. Yeah, when he's chewing, the food's like, we need to go down the tunnel. Don't go out the airlock. Ah, you're out in the space. He would be yelling at me. He'd be yelling at me about, like, serious shit. He'd be like, Dan, you need to put the damn hydraulic in the crane or else thing ain't gonna work. And I'd just be looking at his teeth like,
clank,
uh-huh, clank, uh-huh, clank, uh-huh, clank, uh-huh, clank, uh-huh. Clank. And then he'd be done. He'd be like, you got that? And he'd be like, Lynn, you're gonna have to hit me with that one more time.
No.
It was insane, but those are the worst teeth I've ever seen were the head processor in Alaska, this Filipino dude named Aladdin, and he had four teeth. That's it. Just on his bottom gum.
Jesus
and
Christ.
And it looked like an old cowboy graveyard. It looked like the tombstones were like barely in there. And he would just,
the way with his Filipino accent, the way he talked, and it was, his teeth would jut out like this, and he'd go like,
He would always walk by if we weren't doing something right. He'd just go, "Nagu, Miss Nagu."
How do you do anything else in your life moving forward, even one day beyond several of your teeth being gone in the front of your face?
Dude, all of
like, you know what I'm saying? Like, how is he there working and telling you what you have to do?
Yeah.
How has his mind already gotten past, like, every thought being like, oh yeah, I should probably eat some of these only having 14. Yeah, I should probably figure something out about only having 14.
How did you know?
I don't, what am I doing? You're yelling at this goofy kid from Colorado's out here.
Dude, I get it, cause every morning that you fucking put your feet on the ground out of bed and then your tongue touches bare gum on the top.
Yeah, that's what I mean. You're like, you just get that runner along, like, just feel no choppers.
Holes. I should probably do something about this.
Just meaty holes.
He goes, it is God's grace. These giving me a perfect diagonal bite down, but he was pretty bad.
I mean, the guy with four only.
Like, the guy was a fucking moron, though.
But you're like, you can get rid of those four and just get fake.
Oh, you're talking about
the
Aladdin?
Worst fake teeth.
Dude, Aladdin didn't give a fuck about anything.
That's what I'm saying. It's amazing.
Working, and he would drink 3/4 a bottle of Jose Cuervo a day.
That's not as much as I thought you were going to say for a guy with four teeth.
When you're at work?
While he was at work.
I mean, dude, by the end of the day.
That was just his work drink.
That was his work drink. That was his Gatorade.
Then it's happy hour.
Dude, then he would go to his house and just get fucking shit.
I'm gonna go down to happy hour.
No, he was Filipino, so he'd be like, yeah, cigarette? I always knew he was starting to get tuned up when he'd come and get a cigarette off me.
Where did he put the cigarette? He had to choose a sign around those four teeth.
He loved me because I'd bum him cigarettes.
Oh,
he
God.
He's actually kind of a funny dude. At one point, I couldn't lighten my forklift up. Like, mm-hmm. with this tote that I'm trying to pick up. And he goes, you have a girlfriend? I go, what? He goes, you don't have a girlfriend, do you? I go, why do you say that? He goes, you have bad aim. And I was like, what does that mean? What, you think you have to aim your dick up like that? How do you fuck, Aladdin?
With lots of aim.
He goes, running start. Yeah, those are the worst teeth I've ever seen in my life.
Oh, that's fucking awful.
Bad teeth are hard not to look at.
By the way, that's what I do with homeless people. I just stare at their teeth. I'm so freaked out by it.
Don't you want to touch bad teeth?
I don't.
Right? No, but Black Lou's nodding. Right? When you see bad teeth, you kind of want to run your finger.
No way.
You just want to feel the texture, right?
Yeah.
See how it goes. Like corduroy pants.
Yeah, I'm a happy camper.
I don't want to do that at all. Do you get that, Jacob? You got to be a prissy, neat freak like me.
Oh, that's perfect. Horrifying. I would never.
You have perfect teeth.
I would never want to touch bad teeth.
How many runs of braces did you have?
Just one. I had them in for a while.
Did you have braces, Jay?
Yeah, and then I had them taken off black market.
Oh, dude, why is that not? Was it a Phillips head screwdriver in your garage?
No, a guy knew a guy who bummed the orthodontal tool.
Did your mom get furious when she saw your braces were gone?
No, it was my stepfather's friend.
So your stepdad Joe was like, yeah, let's help him. Let's help him out.
Let's get him off because he's been, I think I wore him for like 7 years or so.
Are you serious?
I mean, not 7 years, but like a long time.
So you were one of the kids that had braces forever when you got-
I just never took care, yeah.
Yeah, but when the braces got off, I don't know if you remember those kids, but when the braces came off, everyone was like, whoa! Like they showed up at school, you'd be like, well, you don't have braces
especially
anymore.
Me because I still had doof teeth. Yeah. Take care of them at all.
Someone goes,
I mean, he gave me a night guard. I'm like, there's not a chance I'll ever wear that.
You never put the headgear on.
I mean, it was like headgear. I don't know why. In all the technology we have in the world, which headgear, by the way, I don't even believe is a thing anymore. And in my growing up, I grew up in a time where they still had to put a fucking, like...
You know, the strap?
Like a catcher's mask. It's never going to happen.
There's nothing better.
I don't wear my Invisaligns now that no one would notice or see. I just don't do. I don't know.
There's nothing funnier than... I was very lucky. Like, I have a fucking gap in between my teeth, and my bottom teeth are not terribly unorganized, but...
I never noticed.
You can go... You can clearly tell, like, I didn't have braces, but I didn't...
fucking bottom teeth are... I hate my bottom teeth so
much. My mom was broke enough to be like, your teeth... Like, my mom looked at my face and was like... She did the thing that I would do to that prostitute. She looked at my teeth and she goes, you're not going to get braces. And I was like, yeah! yeah! At the time, I was like, no braces! Because I remember sleeping over at my friend Andrew's house and watching him put on his headgear, and I was like laughing, because I was like, this is hilarious.
Cause he's what you're supposed to do.
He's like, hold on real quick, Ian. I can't put on my, yeah. my headgear, and he's like, ugh. Like he was getting prepared to get shot out into space.
Yeah. Oh, there's no way. I wouldn't do that in front of my friends.
Yeah. Oh, oh look at that. Oh, God, headgear. And they just, it's locked in. You really do look like you're playing a VR game.
You know, mine wasn't even like that, so tight across the, against the, mine was the one where it came out.
Dude, I remember my friend Mike.
Hang on, let me see if we can find one that's like more like the one.
My friend Mike, who's an NFL coach now, the one that coaches for the Niners, he had braces so long that when he got his braces off, I remember just like looking at him being like, your teeth are fucking huge. Cause you know, cause with the braces on, his teeth look tiny and he got them off and you're like, you got some big ass teeth.
Big tooth motherfucker.
Yeah, he's all, I always wanted, the one time I was jealous of kids with braces is when they did get them off cause they talked about how good it felt. And you're kind of like,
I want to feel that good.
Yeah, you're like, I want to
make me feel good.
No wonder, I'm surprised I didn't do needle drugs because that was my instinct where I want to be like, I want something to take the pain away.
I
want to
feel good like you.
I want something to feel bad and then to feel great.
Make me feel good, braces.
So you had braces over a year, over 2 years?
I mean, maybe like six.
That's crazy that you just bailed. You're just like, you almost did more damage not.
Kurt Metzger had braces when I met him.
That's great. This, you're doing celebrities with braces. Oh, no. Look at Gwen Stefani had him.
Hey, baby, hey.
Hey.
Ain't nobody gonna rock this place. P-A-N-A-N-A-S. Ain't no hollaback.
Yeah, adult braces are the best. Because that's really someone trying to get it together at the very... That's someone doing their homework the night before.
Yeah, but here's Justin Silver. He's got gorgeously perfect teeth. Makes me furious.
When did that become a practice, putting braces on? Cause that's some real, we've beaten the animal shit. We've got to turn in.
You can probably find that, the history of the braces.
Oh dude, why isn't someone needs, Ken Burns needs to do a braces documentary.
Well, they all used to have wooden teeth when like George Washington and all them. I'm a bit of a history buff.
And now we got, it's platinum teeth. Do you follow the history of hip hop?
You know, what the black people tell me.
Fucking Lil Wayne has all, and then that Kodak Black who had the grossest gold teeth ever. They look like actual gold nuggets, like bouillon.
Like he got them out of a river?
Yeah, like he found teeth by sifting a basket of sand.
Can you find Kodak Black's gold teeth? Because I want to see his fucking prospector mouth.
Well, now he got him changed out for some diamonds.
I got so much gold, I had it put in my mouth. Teeth.
Like that's bouillon.
Dude, that would have been great if he would have gone by the name Prospector.
He got him changed though. He got him changed now. No, get to a picture of his actual. I mean, his teeth are so good. They were yellow gold.
Is that it?
Like a yeah.
Dude, that really does look like gold nuggets.
Yeah.
It's so awful.
His teeth look like those little chocolate eggs wrapped in tinfoil.
Yeah. Yeah.
You, like you could pick out his teeth and underneath his chocolate. You Kodak, why did you not tell me that your teeth are made from Cadbury milk chocolate?
Oh my god! And then he got
he was the one with
now he got the diamond ones put in, right?
Well, he's the one that they were saying fucked Cash Me Outside girl.
I think she was alluding to it. I don't think... here's the thing. It probably did happen.
I got gold teeth. I need a young wife for all that prospecting I'm doing.
Any word on her tour?
No, it failed. Obviously, it failed.
Did it?
I mean, it hasn't been announced.
Did it even happen yet?
Who gives a shit?
I'm curious if she did a show.
Ah, man, probably not.
I mean, she's so off the radar.
But that, would you expect anything?
That was a wrap of that.
It's not like she put out a fucking acoustic LP and we're like, ooh, this one's gonna grow.
Tell said something you used her as a reference on stage this week in Montreal last week. Yeah, it was great. It's really funny.
Oh, wait, was I there? I feel like I was at that show.
I think so, yeah. We were in the green room watching it, right?
Her summer tour was postponed.
Yeah, I just got here.
Oh, okay. Oh no. All those people
why is it postponed? She goes, she's losing her voice, so.
She goes, she has this nodule on her.
Yeah, she can't hit the notes.
She has to have vocal cord surgery. It says fans of the infamous Catch Me Outside teen will have to wait to see her perform live. Her summer tour is being postponed until further notice. Her leech, Adam Kluger, told the Post. That's her manager. who's battling her baffling rise. Okay, this is all bullshit.
See what see who else Adam Kluger manages. I bet it's
hold
all
on,
that.
Hold
shit.
On. Wait, go down. Christine, don't move because it says her manager said the team is pushing the shows back to align better with other initiatives. What do you use fucking obtuse language,
oh,
you
he
asshole.
Says, he says, due to overwhelming response, they're going to look at larger venues. Well,
oh, God damn it. I really had hope.
And better soon her growing. Is she growing? You know, maybe she is, and I don't see
she
it.
Just broke through in the Asian market.
That's K-pop?
Yeah, now she's like,
don't let me go. Don't let me go.
That's me outside. I love number one girl, Daniel Bijoli.
She got your heart tiny.
I love Christmas girl.
Yeah, that
I wear Google uniform, love Cashmere Side girl.
Hello, Mush Mushy. Hello, Daniel Bijoli.
There's no way that show's gonna be even like if you're bummed that it got rescheduled, that should be the clue that we get to kill you.
Oh, motherfucker, I might be deployed when she comes back around.
Unless you're a soldier, and then thank you for serving. But if you were bummed around...
If you're upset that you're going to be deployed...
Well, let me tell you what happened. I got back from overseas. Your grandma had 2 tickets to catch me outside live. I knew right then I wanted to marry her.
Oh, I wrote a letter home. Don't you sort of know who her manager manages? Because I bet it's a bunch of those kind of people, right?
It actually isn't.
It's probably big people, huh?
Yeah, he was named.
That dude probably makes money.
He was named by, in 2012, Forbes named Kluger one of the 30 most influential people in the music industry under the age of 30.
Oh, man.
Oh, dude.
$5 million a year in revenue.
He worked with Interscope. We just watched the Defiant Ones.
Wait, his clients have this?
Lady Gaga.
Gaga, Kesha,
Flo Rida,
Jennifer Lopez.
Wow.
Beyonce, Eminem. Where do you see Flo Rida?
Up here, including Flo Rida's video.
Oh, okay. But I mean, this guy has the biggest. So it must clearly be like this. This guy, Adam Kluger, is like, I can make $3 million.
Wait a second.
Yeah, but he also started his PR.
Basically, he's a genius. What he did actually, that Flo Rida thing, you guys read that too fast.
Mm-hmm.
He actually he did product placement deals for a brand called Drank in a bunch of hip hop videos.
Okay.
So he said he got a ton of money off that. That's pretty awesome.
Yeah. When you look it up, it's a PR agency.
Okay. Well, that's why. That makes sense.
He knows how to exploit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So he's probably going to make a shit ton of money.
I think he should get bigger venues. Well, stay tuned. We'll
Oh, yeah, dude. I'm excited to see her live at the O2 Arena. The British will really enjoy that.
She's very dry.
Oh, absolutely love what she's doing now. She's progressed into a different artist. I feel like she's really getting to the core of what makes an artist great.
Fuck you, Ma! Yeah. My pussy great!
She comes out and fights her mom first and foremost.
I thought the second act was a little stale until the third act where they brought Danielle out and she called her mother a cunt several times. I found that to be very amusing. I found the way that she threw an open-hand punch at her mother's face during a question. That reminded me of when I saw Shakespeare live.
Brilliant.
Brilliant. Absolutely 5 stars. The Guardian says it's the show of shows.
Fuck you, Dennis.
A surprise guest set by one of the women from the Wild and Weird Whites of West Virginia.
Her name is, oh, I know her name, too. I know them all.
Tammy?
There's something like that. No, it's not Tammy.
What was it? What, who's going to get some dick?
Oh, Mousy.
That's right. Mousy gonna get some dick tonight.
God damn it.
By the way,
I wanna watch that movie tonight,
those,
I think.
Those gigs already right now, 0 tickets available. That's a very strategically worded sentence.
Yeah.
It's saying there's 0 tickets available, as in they're not selling tickets yet, or it's sold out. That's a very different thing.
It's like,
dude, I'm doing Carnegie Hall.
What?
I'm doing Carnegie Hall.
Congratulations.
Yeah, yeah.
Can I get tickets?
There's no tickets as of right now, so I can't say yes to that. Right now there are no tickets.
You heard it here
first.
They
don't exist.
Jay Oakerson sold out Carnegie Hall.
No one's ever made. Yeah.
That's such, you're right.
No ticket has been made for it.
But that's PR.
There are no tickets for me at Carnegie Hall as we speak.
If there is a live Catch Me Outside girl, we have to go.
Yeah.
Oh, if it makes its way to New York?
Yeah.
Dude, I'll camp out for tickets dressed like her.
We'll just have Jacob wear his Moon Tower outfit.
Wear your Corey Feldman shirt there.
Or no, when he dressed me up as Catch Me Outside Girl.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. Oh, dude, absolutely.
If you really are, I really feel like that should be, because the world's becoming overpopulated, that they should set certain things up to see who we should murder. Yeah. Whose family we should wipe out?
Just throw the Molotov cocktail in?
Yeah, like if you come
I'm
up...
I'm not going to co-sign that because there are lunatics that will just do that to her show.
Oh, no. I'm not talking about her. I'm saying if you're bummed that the show got postponed, that should have been a sign that you're no longer allowed to breed.
Oh, yeah. That should be, Idiocracy.
Yeah, Idiocracy.
They should cut off your dick.
You're like, you're done. You're too dumb. You're too dumb
to wag this dick around, man.
Even though I said we want to go, I'm not bummed that it's postponed. I'm saying if you were genuinely, like... bummed.
Yeah, like, fuck.
Like, I took my shift off Applebee's for that.
Great.
Hey, listen, Derek, I cannot work August 22nd. You go to your manager.
Listen,
you go
to the I'll do doubles shift. Until then.
Yeah, dude, I mean, seriously, I'll pick up anyone's shift. I'm telling you right now, August 22nd, I have to be at this amphitheater. I'm not missing this live show. You just see, like, us, on Sunday we saw Trent Reznor and Nine Inch Nails perform arguably one of the best live shows I've seen because it had the elements of, it was visual, the music was great. Trent Reznor pours himself into that. This is like a money grab. So it's going to be a shit show. So if you're...
Maybe we'll find out after the break. Maybe we decided to go with Nine Inch Nails music for the...
Maybe we didn't.
Maybe we didn't.
Maybe we have fight music because it's another awkward changeover with the fugue.
I guess we'll find out when we come back. Oh, yeah. Every commercial we come back, we may have had a weird thing with the fugue.
Yeah, we'll tell you if the fugue, if it's going off the rails with the fugue or not.
Yeah, we'll have to let you know. We'll be right back. It's the Bonfire.
And now, back to the Bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
Linkin Park's Crawling is part of our Choke Jerk Thursday.
Choke Jerk Thursdays.
We're doing all people that Jay suspects of dying of choke jerk.
Suspects. Cold hard facts.
It's not whole cold hard facts. If I learned anything getting my journalism degree, you need to say, sources say, choke jerk.
What if I were to say, I'm about to leak a video of all these guys choke jerking successfully before?
It's all on your cell phone. And they go, Jay, you got it? Here we go.
I'm a spotter to the stars.
Spotter Jay.
Sometimes they just get too overzealous and they try to do it without me.
We could do that we could do that as a whole web series. You as a choke jerk spotter.
Choke jerk spot.
Where you come in with a fucking weight belt.
Come on.
Like a bench press shirt.
Oh, dude, I like the weight belt, but I like the belt that the Home Depot guys wear with the suspenders built into it.
Back brace, dog.
Yeah.
I thought when they told me I was going to unload trucks when I worked at Bed Bath & Beyond, I got the first question in the interview, I go, do I get a back brace? And they go, if you need one. And I was like, I probably need one.
You got my back's all fucked up.
But they're like, you have to buy those. You bring those from home.
Oh, you thought it was like it was a government issue?
I thought it was BBB or issued. Oh, is this a Bed Bath & Beyond one? Oh, y'all's fit tight.
Oh, I like your guys' back braces.
Oh, I'm going to get so many boxes of loofahs off that truck.
Oh, yeah, choke jerk spotter. That wouldn't be a bad gig.
Be great. I mean, it'd be real awkward.
You're like, I won't tell. I'll tell everybody.
I'm going to tell everybody and my name.
I'm a bad secret keeper on juicy stuff.
I'd be Dan the Shadow Soder. I'm just in the background. You just have a choke jerk. Things get out of control, I'm there to get you. Oh, he's going down. Oh. Pick him up. Pick him up.
Go. He's nodding.
He's out.
He's nodding.
Oh, God.
Got him. Scoop him up.
That's a good rope.
Hey,
good rope.
Hey, okay. Hey.
You're coming. Hey, you're coming all over me.
Hey, oh, come on now. Come on.
His feet all kicked all the shampoo off the fucking...
Yeah. Wake up, Matt Damon. That's going to be extra.
Yeah. Ben Kingsley, wake up. And then you just choke jerk.
Hey. Robert Forster.
Yeah. Hey. Senator Joe Lieberman, wake up. I know you're choke jerking. Get up, buddy.
Hey. Gallagher 2.
Yeah.
Come on. Hey.
former Dallas Cowboys quarterback Troy Aikman. Wake up. I know you just choke jerked. I didn't know you were choke jerking. But I'll tell you this, as a Niner fan, I let him go under for a little bit longer than he should have.
I don't care if he loses a few brain cells. So I just don't want to wake up and not remember who he is.
It's not going to make up for them beating us in 95 in the NFC Championship game.
I don't want to wake up thinking he's Deion Sanders. The guy, you know.
Troy Aikman, former quarterback Troy Aikman, strokes out because of an attempted suicide. With us here, choke jerk spotter, Jay Oakerson.
Yeah, I told him I'd be there 15 minutes, and this guy said he had to start in 10. Yeah. So, you know, he's a fast spurter, and I got there a little bit late to the game, but I was able to get him up, pump life back into him, saw life come back to his lips, and here we are.
Still got some zip on that ball. He played catch with me in the backyard after I spotted him.
Hey, Donald Fagan, one half of Steely Dan.
Yeah. Robert, casino magnate Robert Wynn, wake up. Oh, dude, those rich, super rich guys, they have to have choke jerk spotters.
Of course, but it's probably like they can probably get a few girls that can carry them.
What a sexy way to do it. This is my fleet of
three girls watch me choke jerk.
Oh, man. Just, yeah, strong, powerful Ecuadorian women.
That'll be a real commercial for how good the stroke jerk is. Because if you have three women present, and if you're paying them to, oh, you know what's funny? You probably, yeah, keep going. We gotta see how many, it's probably not that many people.
Welcome to the first ever,
of course,
choke jerk invitational. Hyde? Who's Hyde?
A well-known Japanese singer and songwriter who was famous for being in the bands X Japan and Zilch. Oh, I like that. Zilch.
It's all dudes.
34 years old. Is that a dude?
No, yeah.
It's a dude.
No chicks are getting caught choke flicking.
Does it say the word he?
Yeah.
Yes. He was found
hanging in his hotel bedroom. I don't think any of the poor should have benefits. Now just let me choke jerk.
Vaughn Baudet was a cartoonist and illustrator who... More on Hyde. Go ahead. Stephen Milligan? Who's that?
Conservative British politician. Oh, of course. Oh, God. Can you imagine?
Sexual, transsexual, unisexual, and omnisexual.
Come on down.
I'll tell you what he was in it.
Come on down to Von Bodie. We got all the sexuals. We got autosexual. We got heterosexual and our new omnisexual. It's like Bob's Furniture. For $699, you can be with any of our omnisexual.
He was considered credited as an influence on the films Wizards and The Lord of the Rings.
No shit.
Yeah, look at that.
Wait, but he died in 75.
By the way, from Utica, New York.
Oh, wow.
With that goofy ass name, didn't you feel like...
Yeah, I thought
this was like a Norwegian. Yeah, like some kind of Norwegian...
Just outside of
black metal god or something.
No. All right, go back, because the next one was Kevin Gilbert.
Created the character Cheech Wizard. Baudet enjoyed sexual experimentation and considered himself to be autosexual, heterosexual, homosexual, manosexual, sado.
Black hood over his face
with a leather strap.
Well, that's how usually you do it. At least the guy bought the gear.
He kicked it at 30.
Who's this? Francisc Coatzera. I mean,
a composer
really...
from the 70s. How do you know this possibly?
Yeah, they're not.
That story went down from generation. That's how, like, the girl puts peanut butter on her pussy so the dog eats it off.
The angel
starts.
Tale.
Yeah.
On September 2nd, 1971, he visited a prostitute and paid her.
He was a musician who worked with such artists as Madonna, Michael Jackson, Eddie Money. Well, that's the Holy Trinity right there.
He was found with a black... God, that guy parties, huh?
Yeah, that's pretty bad. He's one of the first... This guy's a pioneer.
He goes, what I told you, I want you to cut off my testicles. She goes, no. He goes, well, can I at least hang myself while I bang you? Goes, yeah, I guess. That girl was like, clearly.
Do you have the song, The Battle of Prague? Do we have that available? He composed two shillings.
To cut off his testicles.
Yeah, which she declined to do. He then tied a noose around his neck and proceeded to have sex with her... until he was dead in the 1700s. Most famous for his song, The Battle of Prague.
Dude, how do you... I mean, as a prostitute, you can be like, I'm not going to cut your nuts off. Cool if I choke while I fuck you? She goes, absolutely.
Let's hear.
Balls, cut off my balls. Cut off my balls.
Would you mind taking a sharp, razor-like object and Nipping off my beans, please.
What have I told you? I wanted my coin purse removed. Take...
Hey, would you mind removing my nutbag? I've got a symphony to compose.
I feel if I had less semen pumping through my veins, I could finally compose the greatest song ever. No? No, you won't? Okay. Well, what if I just, like, put this noose here, and then I hit it from the back?
Madam, would you do me the honor of removing my marbles while I put this black hood over my face?
I'm going to put this hood over my face, and when I pull it off, I better not have testicles.
And then I would like to have sex with you until I am, in fact, dead.
Yes. A gentleman's way out. Bleeding from the testicles, dead due to fucking.
All right, who's next?
I'm off.
And goodbye.
That's it? Nah, dude, that was a real fucking rancor. You really stretched.
Yeah, real nice.
Okay, well.
Real nice.
That ends, well, there you go.
Telling people that they died of autoerotic asphyxiation.
There's more people. Yeah, they stopped doing it. I'm telling you, because these people, now it's their legacy.
There is, you know.
I think of David Carradine jerking off before I think of Kill Bill.
Real or more than Kung Fu?
Yeah.
You think of autoerotic asphyxiation.
I think he died jerking off, right? Am I crazy, everybody?
I mean, he did die jerking off.
Yeah. And that's the first thing you think of. That supersedes Kill Bill.
This is going to start to get real deep for you. Like, deep, deep conspiracy theories. We're like, what if I told you that Kennedy was jerking off in the Cadillac as he got shot?
I bet if you look it up, I'm not the only person who says this. I bet if you look up autoerotic asphyxiation, suicide conspiracy theories, autoerotic asphyxiation.
Look it up, because I want to see how dark this rabbit hole goes.
I've converted Lou, I believe.
Yeah, I'm a believer.
Are you a believer?
I believe this theory now.
I have to meet someone in a parking garage on 23rd Street. Please. He's like, I have files.
By the way, I call people that believe in me believers.
Oh, yeah? Where'd you get that from?
You're trying to steal that away? Justin Bieber goes, what happened to my fan base? It's a bunch of dudes who think celebrities killed themselves by choke jerk.
You're not a believer. You're a Bolokerson.
You're a Bolokerson.
You're a Bolokerson or a Beloader.
I don't think... I mean, you're right that it ruins their legacy, so they don't want to fucking be known for it, but I don't think...
Well, there's also a story going around that they were murdered to cover up a pedophile ring.
That's the other conspiracy? Who was?
That's Snopes, that Chester Bennington and Chris Cornell were murdered to cover up a pedophile ring.
But wasn't Chester, didn't somebody touch his thing when he was little?
I think so. I think he was molested.
His dinger? You can't do that scream at all unless somebody touched your dick against your will.
That's what gives you that range?
Yeah, it's on Snopes.
What is Snopes?
Website.
It's a fake news?
Yeah.
Fake news. It's false. Oh, rating false. So someone just fucking...
But there's really, like, I'm surprised that I'm not seeing more about this.
I'm the only one with the balls to say it. And I might be killed for it, guys. But please, Lou, if I die, keep the story going. It's the most important thing.
I was trying to see if the story was real. Like, his wife... after he died, apparently went on Twitter
and
was saying stuff about, like, that she was sleeping with Mike. There's a thing that she was sleeping with Mike Shinoda.
Oh, that'd be so great.
But I like, haven't been able to find if this is fake news or not.
Well, you've been off screaming in other bands. He's been rapping in my sniz.
And I'm gonna fuck you better.
Yo, 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 yo.
This is my pussy now. Yeah, I don't know how deep this theory goes. I'm a Cornell fan. I'm sorry, dude.
Huh?
I'm a Cornell fan.
And you couldn't be a fan of anyone's talent if they decide also on their own free time?
Very good point.
To jack off while they choke themselves? I bet you're into some weird shit.
Very good point.
You're not. I know you're not into any weird shit at all.
I'm into I have sex missionary.
Missionary and doggy, I feel like. That's it.
I go from the side sometimes.
You hit it from the side?
Yeah.
While you're laying on your side?
Yeah.
Ooh, you two got a big piece. That's a big piece right there, Lou. You don't know about that.
That's not an angle.
Do you? I'm not talking to you, Black Lou. I know you know what I'm talking about.
It's all angle.
We saw your wife's face at the Corey Feldman show. She gets it.
She looked exhausted.
That's when Black Lou was like, yo, we're going to leave after the second song. You ain't getting this dick tonight.
She goes, let's go right now. She goes, I don't like it. He's sad. It's sad.
not watching him.
Hey,
he's
I
got a
know.
Big one. You know that.
Oh, I guess somebody wants to be walking around all normal at work tomorrow.
Yeah. Oh, you don't want to be Ms. Sheriff tomorrow? Or
all right. I guess we can watch Corey Feldman. I always got to blow your booty hole out.
I'm going to do it on the car, in the car, too.
I guess I'm about to blow your booty hole out in the car now. Poor Uber owner.
He's got some balls and some cocks.
Oh, yeah, I love that. You pulled that from What the Hell Happened to Me?
Yes.
Cock and balls?
I knew you'd like it.
Oh, yeah. Just lay under the tree and play with your cock and balls. Wait, what was it? Oh, you did not find it?
I think it was a hack. I think her Twitter got hacked, but right after he
what
died.
What a fucking mean thing to tweet.
Yeah, it's really...
What did it say? What was the tweet?
I love Mike. We all move on fast. I'm glad he killed himself.
Jesus.
I guess this is the time to say it, but I should have been cheating on Chester with Mike Shinoda. Like, and it says it was a hack.
I mean, it must be.
But this went out from her, like, verified account.
But, man, what kind of fucking scumbag would do
yeah,
that?
Yeah, what kind of dickhead
like, why would you, what could you possibly hate Linkin Park for that much? Like, you know what I mean? Like, listen, I hate certain celebrities. I hate Eddie Vedder. Now, I don't know how to say it, but I certainly wouldn't hack his thing and be like, hey, I'm Eddie Vedder. I totally like to suck my friend Lou's dick. Oh, I would say that. That'd make you so cool in the hood.
Lou would be like, thank you.
No, I don't hate, I don't think I hate any celebrity.
That's a very malicious.
But I mean, that's beyond hate. That's just like, that's pure evil.
Yeah, just to be like, to do that to someone whose husband just killed himself is pretty fucked up.
Yeah.
But I'm trying to find the argument of like, no, it was funny. It's like, nah, not really.
Can we, look at that. Look at that.
Coming up. When you type in autoerotic asphyxiation.
Law enforcement sources tell us the singer hanged himself. Why is it not hung? Why is it hanged?
I don't know why it's hanged.
He hanged himself at a private residence in Palos Verdes Estates in L.A. County. His body was discovered Thursday just before 9 a.m. He was married with 6 children and from 2 wives.
Jeez, I didn't know he had 6 kids.
The singer, fucking pull out. I hit it in the chops every now and again. The singer struggled with drugs and alcohol for years. He had said in the past he considered committing suicide because he had been abused as a child by an older male. Another famous person dies by means of autoerotic asphyxiation. Grunge rocker Chris Cornell was found dead. Police investigate possible suicide. And he hangs himself. Police investigate possible suicide. And it was on Cornell's birthday.
As was with most who die by means of autoerotic asphyxiation, the body is found with a rope or a belt around the neck, pants down, etc. The police will claim that the death is an apparent suicide. Better to comment suicide commit suicide than to die while masturbating. Famous people who died by means of
autoerotic asphyxiation.
Look at this updated list.
Number one, Robin Williams.
Hey, I'm in first person on the list.
Number one.
Oh, I'm joking. I'm going out.
Number one.
Everything's turning white. Everything's black.
Oh, now I'm so hard. Now I'm so, I'm so soft.
Oh, I'm about to get there. Oh, God. Stomach pancakes.
Of course.
Some of it hit my face.
Oh, my God. Look at me. Oh, I'm spurting. I'm like an oil well. David Carradine, Chris Cornell, Michael Hutchins. Same list,
except they've added
Martin Luther.
Chester Bennington.
From Luther? Yeah.
Luther, look that up.
And then Chester Bennington was added to the list. I mean, your theory, someone's grabbing hold to it.
Holds up completely.
This is on what? Roman Catholic Imperialist blogspot.com. So this is a guy. This is just a guy in his basement that probably listens to the show. This is a guy who's just like, I like Jay.
These are coming up all over the place. And really, I was talking to somebody in Montreal when I brought up autoerotic asphyxiation. No, it was the first time I saw somebody really get almost like offended by the idea. And really, it kind of comes down to, I'm like, these deaths are terrible. It really sucks these guys are dead young. But I think this is like a thing that needs to be talked about, shooting heroin in your arm. Like, you shouldn't be, it sucks that they're doing it, but it's almost like, hey guys, don't autoerotic asphyxiate yourselves. Like, you could die.
How do we make a belt that's a breakaway belt? Like an emergency. We could be sitting on millions of
dollars. It's like if heroin addicts are going to do heroin, you got to give them clean needles.
And you know who's a billionaire? The guy who invented methadone. So why don't we invent the methadone?
The breakaway. Like the safe word. Release hatch or something?
Yeah, where you can just pull a strip and you're gone. And then it just, everything collapses and you're out.
Because once you're unconscious, you're unconscious.
It's gotta be something about your unconscious releasing it.
Oh, dead body weight. If you drop below a certain thing. We could do this. I'm sure we could create this. Listen, we made the
dildo. You're getting some lofty science fiction ideas, though, when you keep saying stuff.
I said that you should be able to fast-forward TV when I was 7. Now, did I create DVR? Possibly.
More than likely,
More than likely, and they stole it from me. TiVo stole it from me. Now, a breakaway choke jerk. Yes, we invented the dildo bike.
We did invent the dildo bike.
Why can't we invent something else?
Can we see what Martin Luther's story of choke jerking is?
I love it. I have a choke jerk. It's not that, Martin Luther.
I love this letter.
I have a dream.
And there was some fine ass white pussy sitting on this motherfucker's face. And I was blasting off.
Let's see what the,
I had a black belt.
A strong black belt.
A strong black belt that I trusted my life into.
I mean, he was assassinated, so that's not.
Why do I wear dress shoes while I masturbate?
I
can't get any grip on this wood floor.
They're slipping and flipping.
I'm flopping around like a fish who just came.
Came glory.
glorious ropes and ropes of jism.
Go to Louis. Christine, go to Martin Luther.
This has to be offensive to somebody.
Absolutely.
Martin Luther looks like Chris Cornell, dude.
No. This is the medical investigator said he's not absolutely convinced the suicide ruling is correct. In theory, it could be an accident.
What's an accident mean?
You
it means you pass out
during
choke jerking.
Yeah, I really don't like that you're right about Chris Cornell. It really upsets me that you're right about Chris.
He fell on bad days.
He's like,
he fell on black days.
And I fell on black days.
Choke jerk?
The way Cornell was found means he was able to regulate the pressure on his
Thank
neck.
Thank you. They're hanging from doorknobs.
Please answer the question.
Dude, that really
Does the defense's case hold water?
Dude, it's best. You just basically, you almost did the Ace Ventura where he goes, Chris Cornell works at Detroit. He's a singer of Soundgarden. Loves sex. Loves to be choked. Was doing a show, came back, and that hey, somebody in the next room could hear him. He regulated the choke jerk.
Listen, great. He was found in a torn gray t-shirt and black under. Why would he be in under? Like, what?
A sweat. It's like if their pants were down, their pants are down. That was information I thought we weren't going to find, but it looked like Chester Bennington was found with his pants down.
Guys.
Does it say that?
Well, that's what that... The thing is that that's not really like a great source.
No, but this... But is there a good
source?
How
do you feel? How do you feel like if one of your friends dies and then you're like, you know, we're in the age of very public statements where people are like,
it was a bright talent that went out to,
you know, but then do you pull those retractions back and be like, by the way, your buddy was choke jerking?
Not at all.
And you're all, fuck yeah, he was.
I wouldn't give a shit at all. Like, if my friend died choke, I'd be like, man, it really must be awesome.
I wouldn't be more sad than if my friend wanted to kill himself or kill herself.
Yeah, I'd almost be happier that it's like they were into some weird freak fuck shit. Yeah,
like, I didn't know they were so sad.
Yeah, so it's better.
Like, that's the thing. That's what I don't get is why it's better to think somebody killed themselves, especially somebody that's leaving behind 6 kids.
Because those 6 kids would want to walk around going, my dad choke jerked to death.
Oh, yeah, that's a rough...
Why'd you lose your dad? Was it, he was a rock star, let me guess, like, he died
heroin.
Banging heroin because he was such a strong songwriter. Like, no. Cartoon Network was on in the background, and he died beating his own dick tied to a doorknob in a hotel room.
He had closed caption on SportsCenter.
It's sad that it's better to say somebody killed themselves.
You know what's going to be weird is when people find out, when people start killing themselves to podcasts, and you're like, he was listening to Mark Maron, and you're all, oh, that's a tough one.
I think Christine wants to go give speeches at schools about not jerking off with a belt around your neck.
You know, I talked to my friend that sat in yesterday is like he was friends with the guy that's in jail now, and they've had like communication. It just really is such a.
I thought you were going to say the other kid that was in here with him was choke jerking.
Oh no!
Ew.
It just really is a thing.
We'll live show that.
Oh jeez.
We'll live. You guys have already heard this.
Yeah, Jay and I hugged. We'll talk about it. Yeah.
That was crazy.
You guys,
that was nuts.
Shut up. We
already talked.
We already talked about it.
But
inside joke.
It's already happened.
It's a scary, one of the things is like he wasn't part of the BDSM community. He was trying to do stuff in private. And BDSM community has a bunch of safe words and it's a whole thing and there's rules and there's regulations. When
so
people
is there
are
a
doing
choke
this
jerk?
Private stuff.
Is there a choke jerk
community? No, because it's a private thing. It's something you do by yourself.
How do you choke jerk?
I mean, there's videos, there's Belt YouTube tutorials on
yes.
how they were found.
Well, let's take a break and come back with that immediately.
Well, are we going to do a how-to choke jerk?
Yes.
All right.
At least a safe way. If we don't take the responsibility
Dan,
for this, nobody will.
Dan believes it.
I believe it
he
now.
He believes it now.
He's starting
this
to.
That's great.
I mean, it makes so much sense.
It makes perfect sense.
And you're right. It is, there is something affirming about it that you're like, oh, okay, he didn't kill himself. He just choked himself.
Yeah, he just really likes to jerk off.
And it says that he
had, Robin Williams, too?
Yeah, he had an Oxycontin addiction, and apparently he's been sober since 2002, but that rush of needing something to feel anything.
I choke jerked myself today to see if I could come focused. On the jerk from the god about the belt.
I choked jerked today while I was in the bathroom.
If I could come again,
I would.
Yeah, they're all choke jerking. My theory is
I jerked off in the bathroom. I hung from the doorknob.
Nothing comes out when I come.
It sounds like air being let out of a bag.
Just looks like my pee hole coughs.
There's a boy who. The needle. One.
Should speed this up.
Well, there you go.
If you want to choke jerk, you just gotta get yourself a strong belt. Yeah, better be made out of leather.
Let me try one. If you want to blow your sticky load, you got to find a low doorknob and get a belt around your neck now.
We'll be right back. It's the bonfire.
And now, back to the bonfire with Big J. Oakerson and Dan Soder.
It's Bonfire, Comedy Central Radio, Sirius XM 95. I'm Dan Soder. That's Big J. Oakerson. And Big J. Oakerson has convinced me that a lot of these celebrity quote-unquote suicides are actually autoerotic asphyxiation gone awry.
I want to disclaim that, by the way, that the website that we're saying is backing me up is the Roman Catholic Imperialist. So, I mean, like, you
it's
know.
It's a blog spot.
Whatever that's worth. I mean, I'm just saying, like, I'm not the only person to think, and it makes a lot of sense.
Back on the show, one of the members of the original lineup of the Bonfire, Murkface Andy,
hey,
hanging out.
Hey, gang.
Woo. Hey, buddy.
Oh, man.
Hi,
Black Lou's giving you the evil eye. Yeah. Don't worry, Black Lou. We'll get his ass
Black
out.
Black Lou, yeah, you still are. Don't worry. We're
no
still all in this
Look,
together.
He's, yeah, he's my pal.
Welcome back. You were saying on the break.
Yeah.
That
in between my junior year and senior year of college, I was living down at outside Villanova in my off-campus house in the summertime, and I was with my buddy, and he got a call in the middle of the night about his younger brother who had passed away, and the next day we found out that he "quote unquote," hanged himself, but it was revealed later on. No, it was on a pull-up bar with a dog leash.
Dude, it's hardcore.
Yeah, and he was found.
He goes, "Hey, mom, I'm just gonna go walk the dog."
And yeah, their younger brother.
She goes, "What?" He goes, "Why'd you laugh like that?" He goes, "What?" And he said, "I'm gonna walk the dog."
I'm going to do some pull-ups with the dog.
Yeah, don't come down if you hear me moaning. This is me getting in shape.
Oh, yeah. I guess I did forget to bring the dog with me.
Oh, the dog's in the backyard? I didn't notice.
Wait, real quick, go back a couple pages here. You had the crime scene. Where do you know that crime scene? The suicide scenes.
Yeah, this was Cornell's suicide scene. They released pictures, so that's the...
Yeah, well, let me see. He did it with one of those, like, the exercise. I'm telling you, dude, this is all choke jerk.
That's like he travels with it?
Yeah.
So he travels with the choke jerk belt.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no, he actually uses that thing where you step on a piece of rubber and
His body was dope.
He does 1920s workouts.
Dude, he does,
and he has a DVD that he watches while Raquel Welch does the same exercise for him.
She goes, 4, 3, 2, get your leg up. Good job.
Oh, yeah. You know what? His last two phone calls were Jillian Michaels and...
Suzanne Summers.
Working out. Welcome to Choke Jerk the Weight Away.
Definite choke tug.
So he did it with, your friend's brother did it with a pull-up bar and a dog leash?
Yeah.
And it later came out that it definitely was.
Yeah.
Was he buck naked?
Well, that's the younger brother. The least youngest kid
sucked
found
him off?
Him. Yeah, maybe. I don't know about that.
After a post-mortem suck-off?
It was one of those things like even...
Now I'm getting horny. Good job.
It's gonna get dark, but like the mom like kind of give like a eulogy. Like she was like, just please, like, you know, however, don't let mistakes like this happen. Please, whatever you do, be careful. Like it was like under the guise of like, all realized he was choke jerking and fucked up.
What can I say about my son Jonathan? He loved to come.
I wish two boys.
He loved to come.
I wish two young men would invent something, perhaps that maybe a voice activated release system or something.
A breakaway.
A breakaway, just something that when it feels your body weight knows to release.
I don't understand certain things like masturbating while being choked or snowboarding out of a helicopter. It's so dangerous and impractical. But if you're gonna do it, be safe.
Choke jerking is the flying squirrel suit of masturbation.
It's cool to glide along the side of a mountain, but you could also smash into that mountain, and then you're covered in cum and death.
You're in cum and hedge.
At least those flying freaks have a little honor when they're scooping their brains up with an ice cream scoop. I had to cut Michael down with a damn butter knife.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, dude,
keep going down. Is there more,
Jay really has convinced me that this is, like...
Oh, I think he's convinced us all.
He played a song, got himself all horned up.
He goes, I'm gonna go choke jerk, I'm gonna have it.
I wanna choke jerk.
I mean...
I'm gonna smack it while I almost pass out.
Can you get us, we talked about it before the break, but a how-to or exactly a step-by-step process of what choke jerking is? Is it that you pass out?
Yes, absolutely. But it's also...
So passing out is absolutely part of it.
Oh, no, you're not supposed to pass out. They are just passing out. But even there would be, like, these fucking dramatic queefs, like, they're artists. They wouldn't... If there was a suicide here, suicide, there'd be a something. A letter, the guitar wouldn't be just sort of strewn, like you just put it down for a second to go do a quick choke jerk and come back and play.
I think like,
the guitar would be like, you know, he would do something
God
with it, like.
Damn it, your theory is correct.
They would say something to their kids. They have a lot of kids, both.
Yeah, they wouldn't just fuck off and not say anything.
Something.
Somebody said there was a suicide note from someone after the fact to cover up.
Yeah, I thought Cornell left a suicide note.
Did he?
I don't remember, but I thought it was.
Whatever you guys think, just know that I wasn't choke jerking, that's for sure. This was real, real dark sadness.
He goes, I
you just write a suicide note every time you choke jerk.
Alright, I'm gonna choke jerk tonight, I think. Better start get working on that note. I feel hopeless and desperate.
He goes, what's been bugging me? What's been bugging me? Work? Diane's been rude. Or he just has it in his pocket where he goes, All right, I got my rubber band workout band. I got my lube. And where is that suicide note?
It'd be funny if you wrote it like a long time ago and always carries the same one around and says things where it's like, he goes, I could,
George
I can't.
Bush has us in two wars.
I was gonna say, it's like, I can't deal with the horrible finale, series finale of Dexter. Like, yeah. That was fucking 6 years ago.
I'm sorry, but this housing collapse has ruined us all.
Yeah.
Like, that's
I will not live in a world where the president is a black man.
You go, oh, well, it stopped in 2016. Yes, with no cum stains it.
Got the yeah. But still, you can see like if someone dropped it. Like,
what if I told you I had a mint David Carradine suicide letter in the actual laminate?
Mint condition.
Mint condition. I mean, this thing has no cum on it.
The resale on this thing, God only knows. How good of a salesman
this
are
was
you?
One of the sandals from Kung Fu? Probably 10 G's.
Yeah, dude, I mean, like, listen, at first I was sort of myself even being like, it looks a little fishy, but it's fun and funny, in the very dark, sad thing that's happening here. People are dying. I'm not numb to that. But the more I thought about it as I'm watching, I'm like, I think I just asked what's happening here. And by the way, I couldn't care less. I almost want to try it and see what the big to-do is.
I don't think you want to do it because it's like trying heroin. I think if you try it and it's great.
Christine's like choked me a little, but nothing like ever like.
Where you think it's going to end?
No, not even.
I mean,
sort of.
You said that he could control the weight of the belt, so he's probably like, that's good. That's better. Oh my God. Good.
I guess there is. There is. Okay.
Oh, God.
Okay. You know what? I'm going to take my time. We're just going to really go over a script for a while.
I think I'm about to. I'm going to edge.
I'm not finding instructions.
Well, find them.
I did find a video. This says guy hangs himself from doorknob, passes out, and dies.
Perfect.
It's actually
yes.
A video of him dying.
Yes.
No, I'm good with that.
You don't want to see this.
I don't want to see it.
That's bad.
Yeah, I don't want to watch that.
Oh, I did. Can I watch and describe it to you guys?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, put it on.
I'm going to look over the Hudson.
Okay. All right. This guy is built.
Oh!
This guy's dick is really.
Wait,
this
guy. I can't see the belt.
The guy dies?
That's what it says.
Hang on.
Deathaddict.com.
I don't like how he has my body almost exactly.
So he's really is choke jerking.
Your dick's bigger than that, though, right? I mean, because he's only got two fingers on his dick, and you can't see the top of it.
Say this, his legs are.
It looks like he's jerking a soft dick.
But his legs are kicking around. Oh, all right. Yeah. Now,
wait.
And when you made the decision.
Look at his dork, though. It wasn't as bad as I thought. He's just got big hands, I guess. Let's see. Hang on. Boner still boner. Really reacting, by the way, the boner.
He's dead.
Did he pop?
No, he's not dead. Oh, wait. And now look. If you don't think that's funny, come on, dude. I'm sorry.
Yeah,
you get what you get the ass for, man. You choke jerk, you might die. But, dude, his dick. Like, back up a little bit, Christine, please. Dude, this is so great. Dude, his dick at the end of that, just you watch it, he's like dead. His dick just goes like.
Dude, it really is. It's like in the WWE. It's like an old WWF where they'd choke him out and their arm would go down.
Yeah.
I mean, after watching, even seeing this video, I think you're right.
That's the only choke jerk.
I mean,
video?
I really think your theory is right. Like, I didn't want to think that, but it really, I think it's right.
I think so too. Yeah.
I mean, all these people that are hanging themselves on doorknobs. Discovered in their underwear, workout bands.
By the way, I gave passes to a few people. Aaron Hernandez and Ariel, whatever the guy's name was, the guy who had the three girls in Cleveland.
Yeah.
I think those guys killed themselves. You can't kill yourself any other way in jail.
Yeah.
I mean, headbutt a wall? I mean, like, you can't, there's no way you could do that to death. Like, you know what I mean? So I think hanging yourself is the only way to do it. And I believe it. And I promise you those guys are hanging from something where their feet are hanging.
Yeah.
You can't make those marks without pods of traction.
Like, they're swinging. I think, I know human beings don't have survival instinct, really, very much. But, like, or else you couldn't kill yourself at all. But, I mean, like, all of that will be a fucking...
Around 500 people die each year playing with asphyxiation. This happens because while people believe they can be careful and remain in control, the mechanics of what happens when pressure is applied to the neck can cause them to lose consciousness suddenly and unexpectedly.
I mean, we're blowing them.
There are two primary dangers. The first and most dangerous occurs when pressure is placed on the neck, impeding the flow of blood out of the head. The carotid arteries.
Carotid arteries.
Carotid arteries are located slightly deeper than the jugular?
It's jugular.
It's jugular. That's misspelled. Jugular veins, making the veins more susceptible to pressure. This causes pressure to build up in the head. When pressure on the neck is released, the sudden flow of blood out of the head creates a siphon effect, dropping blood pressure in the head and causing instantaneous loss of consciousness. If the rope around the neck is tied off when this happens, death is likely the result. So we need to make our breakaway rope not able to tie off.
Yeah.
I mean, we're starting the science of this. We're going to make millions of dollars.
I believe this is going to be the thing that's going to make us... We're going to retire on this.
I can't wait to have a gold boat.
Invent a breakaway choke jerk belt.
Why do you mean... Stop saying somebody.
We're going to do it. We have a patent. Patent pending.
Yeah. I just don't know how you can do it once you're unconscious.
Copyright bonfire breakaway choke jerk belt. What are we going to call it? We get to name it.
Move forward on this video here.
What should we call it? Choke away?
No.
Because get it? Choke is like a double entendre.
Okay, so this is a sudden consciousness syndrome.
Okay.
The following incident occurred during filming for an asphyxiated themed website.
So let's see, there's a girl.
Oh, girl jerk choke? Choke jerk?
This isn't a choke jerk.
This is just asphyxiation.
She lives, right?
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Yeah, well, there's another person. I mean, I don't think
he's in a kiss mask.
Yeah, it's Gene Simmons.
Yeah, it's the demon. Oh,
she's unconscious. Look at her eyes roll.
Oh, my God.
She's fine.
He's all, hey, Pam.
She's alive.
Hey, Pam. Yep. She goes, I'm cool. Alcohol.
Yeah, that's it. You pass out. But if you pass out and you're still, and no one's there to release you, you're fucked.
What's she saying?
Is that music on the video?
Oh, it just got real. Back it up, because she just got real. She was like, I just choked, and he goes, are you doing okay now?
I'm really dizzy.
Sorry.
Their lovemaking must be beautiful.
Oh, yeah. You're right. Absolutely. I think you're right about that, Jacob.
Oh, yeah. She's not in a good way.
But yeah, if he wasn't there to kind of like release that thing,
oh, she would have been dead.
She'd die.
Let's watch this again in greater detail.
Fuck no.
The director intended to raise the actress to a level she could comfortably handle, but she was raised a little too high, putting pressure on her neck.
Right. Now, if you got a handful of cock when you do this, you're dealing with more than you can handle. You go, who's trying to make this official video?
Whoa.
He goes, if you got your putt in your paw, don't do this.
I'm John Walsh, and this is Choke Jerk to Death.
A lot of people don't know, I lost my second son to a choke jerk. John Walsh, haven't you been through enough?
Couldn't deal with his brother's kidnapping, and therefore became a choke jerk addict.
I'm John Walsh. We're going around the country trying to find people who have died from choke jerking. I don't know if I'm a terrible parent or if I say a bad luck.
Go ahead, let's see what the...
Instant, she completely lost consciousness and her eyes rolled back in her head.
True that.
The director quickly recognized what had happened and lifted her to take all the pressure off her neck. This restored blood flow and she quickly regained consciousness.
Are you okay? Okay, you're not.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Oh shit, I wasn't expecting that.
Oh fuck, I just got really dizzy. Oh, sorry.
She doesn't even know what happened.
Yeah.
This is what often happens to people who play with nooses. And if the loose end of the rope is tied off to anything when it happens, and there is no one present to save them, the most likely result is death. It doesn't happen this way every time, but it only needs to happen once.
They should hire spotters.
Jay Oakerson, jerk joke detective.
Here we go.
Happened in the infamous video of the Syrian girl who hanged herself on camera.
Jesus, I don't want to watch this.
She was experimenting with asphyxiation by noose.
All right, you guys look away anyway.
She first tried gently lowering herself, but that didn't get the effect she was looking for, so she gradually became more ambitious. Finally, she allowed herself to drop. She was using a slipknot, and it cinched tight, completely shutting off blood flow to the head. Instantly, her hands curl. This is caused by hypoxia cramps, the same as you see in a heat stroke victim. By stopping blood flow through the neck, she had effectively shut down blood flow throughout her body.
One has to perform to the capillary.
Hold on, Jay's down. Jay's out.
When the flow is stopped, the effects of hypoxia are instantaneous.
What happened? Did I come?
The girl can be seen trying to get back to her feet.
Right in the cup. What happened? Did I come? Did I hit Jacob?
And cramps.
Did I get it on Jacob? I was aiming for Jacob.
Yeah, good boy.
While this girl's death is tragic.
Oh, she died.
Yeah. Why is this Rock Your World so much? It's complete. It's the stupidest fucking thing I've ever seen.
A video of a girl dying.
It's a video of a girl killing herself stupidly. Oh, this wasn't to jerk.
No.
That was just to kill herself.
Yeah.
It said she was just playing around with asphyxiation.
Oh, right.
Yeah, what a fucked up way to spin your friend's suicide, where you go, he's just playing with eating bullets. He's just playing around with it.
No, but that's, I think she's right about it. I think she was, it was, because look, she could stand the entire time. It was to joke, it was to fucking see how, to pass out, and she ended up did pass out.
The pass out game, which we've talked about.
Oh, well, that was something they said, that there's tons of deaths, like, I forget what article I was looking up, but kids that play the choke game, and a lot of deaths take place in that too. I don't know what this obsession with passing out is.
Because you come back, it's like waking up from a deep nap. You go, bah! I'm back. Yeah, no, we should also, yeah, that's not something you fuck around with at home. It's not a good idea to just fucking see if you could choke yourself to the limit. Push it to the limit. Police can't even say how many lives choking game is claimed. When's this from? 2016, September. It's a New York Post. It says, search how to play choking game online and you might get a clue to the root of deadly tragedy among kids. Thousands of videos and tutorials crop up showing the risky phenomenon in which kids force themselves to pass out, either by their own means or by having a friend choke them, which is something I did in middle school. It was very dumb. In order to experience the supposed euphoria of well-breathing again, it's not new to the internet or the playground, but it makes headlines again after an 11-year-old boy in South Carolina died last week after allegedly playing the game in his bedroom. Choke jerk. He's 11.
Game? Oh, 11? Oh, this is your best choke jerk years.
That's young. That's rookie season. Yeah, if kids are doing it, it makes sense that adults are doing it with the addition of masturbation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what I mean?
How do you adult up this just pass out game?
Yeah, you always put sex on any fun
That's
game.
That's a jerk.
Yeah.
Throw a jerk on
What childhood?
But that's, I mean, I'm more curious on how you get to choke jerking. Like, how do you...
Someone tells you.
Does someone tell you?
I think if someone telling you, it's pretty awesome. Yeah.
The sell on that has to be like, dude, you like to come, right? You love busting nuts? Well,
dude, it's got to be the shit. It's got to be so good.
You don't want to try it, though.
Because
then you get addicted to doing it. Dude,
wants to try it.
Just to see, just to try a little bit.
God Plus, damn it. You know, Stu will be there holding his back.
If Choke Jerk takes out 30% of the show,
oh, that'd be so great.
No, we got spotters. We spot each other.
Yeah, we watch each other. Black Lou, I'll do you.
Yeah, I'll Snapchat it.
Yeah. At the Bonfire, SXM on Twitter, Instagram, Snapchat, if you want to watch all of us experiment with Choke Jerk.
We all lean against the doorknobs, and then we all...
Yeah, Vecchione takes over for
I
me.
I think we're all hanging off of one doorknob, like when like one dog walker's walking five dogs.
Well, we're just bumping shoulders.
All just half dying together. I really made everybody come around.
I mean, dude, it's a theory that I thought was stupid at first and funny, like fun to play around with on the show, but now I'm like, it just makes a lot of logical sense that these celebrities are not killing themselves, but falling. But
have we convinced the room? Lou was convinced. Jacob, you're convinced? Totally.
I was convinced a while ago. You did.
Black Lou?
I gotta be honest, I was skeptical up until you guys went to Montreal and you spoke about it in Montreal, and now I'm all on board.
Yeah,
100% on board now.
I mean, let's see. You know what? Put out on Twitter, at the Bonfire SXM, a poll for the campers. Do you believe Jay's choke jerk theory? Because I think it's true, and I'll vote yes on that. And I think you'd be surprised to find an overwhelming amount of people believe in it.
By now. I think I've turned the world at this point.
I mean, I think you're a genius. I think you're a trendsetter and a genius.
Can you also look up, Christine, the effect of choke jerk also... Like rivals the feeling of
heroin.
Yeah, opiates.
Yeah, because they said a lot of like former opiate addicts do it. And so that might be.
Which explains why rock stars are hitting it so hard.
Yeah, because they're like done. I mean, who's. If we do a choke jerk pool, Anthony Kiedis, is he our biggest?
Is he next to go?
Is he the next to go in the choke jerk?
The choke jerker? You think he's a thrill seeker like that?
I don't know.
We're not gonna choke you.
I don't know if that.
What you get? You get to hang me from a doorknob. What you get? You get to hang me from a doorknob.
Choke it away! Choke it away! Choke it away now!
Boom! Yeah. I mean, if who else would we guess would die of choke jerking?
Flea.
So Red Hot Chili Peppers are one guess.
Yeah, what, the Red Hot Chili Peppers themselves?
Except not the drum, not Chad Smith, who looks like Will Ferrell. Who's going to be choked?
Lou? I say Lou or Stu is next.
No, wait. I mean, Lou.
Am I choked during Deadpool? Lou and Stu together.
Former rock stars. You have to go rock stars.
Yeah, or current rock stars.
Current rock stars.
Manson just keeps doing drugs.
Yeah.
So it won't be him. It's guys that try to kick.
Scott Weiland's already dead.
Yeah.
Scott Weiland probably would have been my number one if he was still alive. Vedder's too balanced. Eddie Vedder likes red wine and lead singer, Hawaii too
he's
much.
He's not horny enough.
Lead okay. singer, The Cure.
Heroin.
Robert Smith? Or Robert, who's the lead singer of The Cure?
Oh, maybe
Robert
a guy. Smith? Maybe a guy in Korn.
Maybe yeah, you think a member of your... Okay. Oh,
there's some religious stuff going
You know which
on
one
there?
Would really hurt, but he never did heroin, I don't think? Dave Grohl.
It doesn't strike me. But maybe Taylor Hawkins. Definitely Pat Smear.
Yeah.
Taylor Hawkins had a problem with heroin, so maybe he'd be a good one.
I bet he has no problem choke jerking, though. I bet that guy's got a rod.
What if the fell dog went out choke jerking?
Surrounded by too much poon.
True. What about Axl Rose? What if Slash did it? Oh, that'd be a
Oh, Axl Rose, maybe. That's Slash. Duff?
Slash.
You think Slash does it?
Yeah, I think he's really...
I feel like Slash is more careful than that. I don't know why.
I don't, yeah?
I just feel like he's more careful than that.
God, who else is on this list of possible choke jerks? We need everyone to go to their house and make sure they're not choke jerking. Tell you this, the next rock star that dies by suicide, immediately I'm going to be like choke jerk because of Jay's theory.
He had a shotgun next to him and his head was blown off. Look, yeah, probably shot himself after he choke jerked. No shame.
You ever came right before you blow your brains out? That's amazing.
That's amazing. But you're supposed to, but he probably fell asleep and his finger weighed down.
You're not supposed to blow the right side of your brain out. You're just supposed to blow out the back of your neck causing tissue damage.
It becomes so hard when you do that.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, on the 1 in 8 million chance you get it, it's so hot.
It's so weird to be like, I want to risk my life for a nut. Jerk off. For one nut.
Yeah.
It must be pretty fucking powerful.
My point, it must be great. It must be so good.
You should have like a Gatorade when you're done doing it. You're catching your breath.
So, Christine, here's what I'll do.
That post-choke jerk come down where you're just drinking a Gatorade. You're like, oh my God. And you start muttering shit like this, Jay.
What the fuck? What the fuck? So sticky.
Housekeeping? Yeah, hold on. One second.
Oh, hang on.
What the fuck?
Hang on, just gotta...
What the fuck?
You can come in. Sorry, this guy. Let me get my pants on. I'll get out of here.
Okay, I'll grab this rubber band.
You like what you see? You liking what you see here? Any luck on this?
It feels like one of those things you don't want to get into because you'll end up dying.
Yeah, but here,
Andy, I'm sorry, your friends.
I have an idea. I'm not. I bet he went doing what he loved.
Yeah.
I'll tell you what we should make for the spotter thing. At least a spotter's noose. What you can do is you can have that, the clips, you clip, like, clothes like a book bag.
Yeah.
Those little black clips.
Oh, they could just push the pressure and it'll let it out?
Carabiners.
That's it. You just push.
Yeah.
Is that the call? You click the sides and it'll just fall and they'll drop.
But if you go out,
It's for a spotter. It's the perfect spotter thing. So you don't, so this way, if you can't carry somebody, Christine can't pick me up.
Yeah, but she can
if
carry
I go down,
me.
But she can loose me go.
And you just hit the ground and you go.
Yeah, plow. Oh, God, that was as good as it said. As good as advertised.
Did you see that? Did you see when that girl choked and passed out and came back? She was speaking gibberish. So your like, first 2 seconds would be like, your first 2 seconds you go, oh. This happened now. Yeah. Oh, fuck the fuck.
Oh, somebody went, damn it.
You go, micro machine sucks. I came everywhere. What?
Oh, it's all over.
Yeah. Christine, did you have to cut me loose?
Dude,
your theory really is, it's solid.
I think that it's, this was, I think we learned a lot today.
We did learn a lot today. And we've gotten to the bottom of choke jerking, so now we've solved it. We don't have to do it again.
I love that we've turned everybody around.
Yeah, we really have.
The whole room is now, but I had Christine a while back.
I'll tell you this. I think I was one of the last to get on board, but I'm on board. Then I believe you.
I'm sorry.
Actually, the first time when I heard the suicide, my head goes to that. I don't know if it's just right. From,
we
like,
get
knowing
it. You and Jay
any kind of suicide?
We get it. You and
no,
Jay
no,
are
no,
simpatico.
The hanging suicide. Like, when you hear it, like, Robin Williams, I was like, oh, it's probably jerking off.
Well, I didn't think so, because I'm an innocent, sweet boy.
Wait a second. Is Christine now just taking my theory and saying, no, I thought of it a little further back than you. Did she just do that?
She's predecessed.
I'm fucking real. She's upstream me.
Check out Big J at Stand Up Live in Phoenix this Thursday
tonight
through Saturday. Go to BigJComedy.com for tickets. And, of course, follow us at The Bonfire SXM on Twitter, Instagram, and Snapchat.
Dan Soder's half-hour special as part of the stand-ups is available right now on Netflix. And you can also catch him in Cleveland at the Accidental Comedy Festival over Labor Day weekend. Get your tickets for that at accidentalcomedy.com. We'll catch you next week on The Bonfire.
Oh, yeah. Oh, we'll probably have a run-in with a fugue. Oh, yeah.